Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. For today's video, I'm going to be sharing with you guys my mom's perfume collection with you all. Well, my mom is a perfume hoarder and I have genetically taken that inheritance from her. So I love buying perfumes too. So I'm going to be sharing with you guys all of the perfumes that we jointly own, and then I'm going to share my favorite perfumes with you, some other things. I'm going to have timestamps right here, so if you want to skip to a particular part, you can right now. So yes, without any further ado, let's get into the video. Okay, before starting with the perfumes that I own, I have to tell you guys a little bit about my taste as well, which I completely forgot. So I do not like fruity fragrances at all. They give me a headache. I am more about the deep dark life. Like, I love opiums and I love ouds and I love all of those fragrances. I like floral as well, but I don't like strong floral at all. Like, strong floral is like a no from my side, a big no. Also, this video only includes the perfumes. They do not include mists and deos and all of that, because then this would have been like a never ending thing. So yeah, now let's just get started. I'm going to start off with my favorite perfumes, and the first one has to be something that has been in my life for so long. I'm talking about Avon Imari Seduction. Now, I don't know if they still make it or not. I have two backups of this, which I'm so scared to use because I'll run out of it. But this is what it looks like. And this was my fragrance for the longest time. Like, I don't think I've been so committed to a perfume as committed as I've been to this. I have repurchased bottles and bottles and bottles of this. I used to wear this to my school and everyone knew me by this. Like, not even kidding you guys. And this is a very deep, beautiful fragrance. What I'll do is I'll write up top notes of each perfume right here while I'm talking about it, so that you guys know about it. I don't want to talk about top notes in every single go because then this video would be too long. So I'm going to write it right here. Second up on my list has to be this baby right here. Now, this is an Itra that I bought from Mehrangarh Fort back in 2005. It was shit expensive. Now, this is pure opium Itra. Oh my god, you literally need the tiniest bit. Look at how much we've used. Like, we have, like, we all use it, all four of us, and this is how much we've used since 2005, and it is amazing. It's so strong, literally stays on all day, all night, every single time. And if you put it on your clothes, no matter what, even if you put them up for a season, like if you put it on a coat or on anything, if you put it up for summers, if you get them out next winters, the fragrance is gonna be there. It's that strong. This baby is such a precious thing to me. And honestly, like, I would buy it again if I ever end up going to Jodhpur or to Mehrangarh Fort, because I know I'll be getting the good stuff. Next, I have the Hermes Twilly, and this was a recent purchase. I bought this in December 2018. And yes, me, my mom, we both like to store our perfumes in boxes. It doesn't matter if it's a Burberry or a Biotique. We have boxes for everything because it just, you know, protects the perfumes from scratches or anything. Until unless you're actually taking out for them for daily use, we keep them in boxes. Only a couple of the perfumes that you'll see here are not in boxes because I don't have the boxes for them. Otherwise, they'll all be in boxes. So Twilly, again, it's such a beautiful fragrance. It's a very light fragrance. It's not supremely heavy on the fragrance. Lasts really well. The bottle is to die for, obviously. But again, the top notes would be right here, so you know what it smells like. I really like it. It's a very, you know, it's not a strong fragrance. It's not in your face, and that's why I love this one, because sometimes I know that my fragrances, personal choices, can be a little too out there and people are like, ooh, intimidated by it. This one is actually a pretty light one, which I love. Next up on my list, as I was telling you guys my preference, I have the YSL Opium as well as the Black Opium. Now, this one is the original packaging, the first time it launched. My mom has had it since forever. This one I bought last year, but I think I've used it before as well and I loved it. I'm just going to quickly show you the bottles as well. And it's very rich, very luxurious, just oof, so good. So this is what the original Opium looks like. The packaging, of course, looks a little boring now, but back in the day, this was the shiz. And this is how the new packaging looks like. It's so much more, you know, deeper, darker, sexier, glittery and everything. And if I've not said, then these perfumes last forever, you guys. Like, they're very, very long lasting. I think YSL overall does a really great job with long lasting perfumes. So if you're someone who's looking for like really long lasting perfumes, try these one out. You're gonna love them. Next up, I have the Jo Malone Peony and Blush Suede. I have the smaller size of this as well. I finished the Neroli one completely because that's a more stronger one. Now, this one is more on the sweeter side. As you can see, it has peony as one of the keynotes in it. But I have to say that Jo Malone isn't the most long-lasting perfume range that I've come across. I feel like I have to reapply side quite often because it doesn't last that long on me. But overall, as a whole experience, I really like them because they are very different ingredients, and you can also mix and match your own perfume, which I really love. Like, you can go to a Jo Malone store and you can pick up two different fragrances and mix and match on your own and just create your own perfume, which I think is really cool and I love it. Alright, next up we have Estee Lauder's Modern Muse. Again, this is more of a sweeter fragrance, but it's a very feminine fragrance. I have to say that there is nothing called as a feminine perfume or a masculine perfume because those are social constructs that we've made in our mind. But just so that you have an idea, I have to say that this is more on the feminine side of things. Even the packaging and everything, it's pretty cute. I do have a couple of more bottles of this. This is not my only bottle. But yes, again, if you're looking for a more sweeter fragrance with a nice lasting power as well, this is the one you should be trying out. Alrighty, next I have Lady Million. Love this stuff. Now for this one, I really really feel it's a strong yet subtle fragrance. Like, it's not supremely in your face, but it still makes a statement. The packaging as well, it's just so luxuriant. I believe like perfumes are more about the experience as well, the packaging and everything, and not just the fragrance. Of course, if you're only about the good stuff, you only care about the fragrance, but I care about the whole experience of it. So again, this one is a nice, strong yet not in your face perfume. So those are my favorite perfumes. Now let's just quickly move on to the other perfumes that I own. I might not have tried all of them out. Like, I might have tried them and sniffed them at the airport or wherever I bought it from, but I'm not really worn them. The first one that comes to my hand is Carolina Herrera's Good Girl. Literally, the packaging made me wanna get it. I've not really worn it out yet. I don't think I have, but this is what the packaging looks like. Like, the stiletto is sexy. Hey, it's so beautiful. The whole vibe, the whole everything. I just love this packaging. And I think I sniffed it and I really liked it as well. Top notes are here, so please check that out. Then I have Chanel's Chance or Chant. I'm not sure how you're supposed to pronounce that. And this one my brother actually bought for my mom for Mother's Day, and I really like it. It's more on the sweeter side of things. It's a very simplistic packaging, no hullabaloo, more about the perfume, more about the story and everything. Now this one is quite a feminine perfume with a really long lasting power as well. Then I have Bulgari's Goldia. I bought this one from Mumbai while I was there for a meet and greet, and I just stumbled upon this and I was like, love it, I should try it out. And this one, again, the packaging is just so beautiful. Like, look at how luxurious that packaging looks. I really like it. And this one, the fragrance on this one it's a mix of like a deeper fragrance and a floral. Like, you would have mixed an oud with some florals, and it's just so beautiful. Again, lasts super 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 long. Then we have Chanel number 5. This is a smaller size. We have tried them earlier as well. This is just a cuter packaging, to be honest. Like, look at how cute this one is. I love the packaging, but I have to say I'm not the biggest fan of this one. I just feel like number 5 is an overhyped kid from the Chanel family. I have tried better perfumes from Chanel. Even their number 3, I find is slightly better than number 5. Next, we have Nina Ricci's Dancing Ribbon. Now, this one was gifted to me by my father. I think when I had reached 50,000 subscribers or 100k or something of that sort. We just all love perfumes. Again, the bottle of this one, it's so beautiful, and this one's a very special perfume to me as well. Not only is the packaging really beautiful, as you can see, but the fragrance is really nice as well. It is on the sweeter side of things, but lasts so well. I really love it. I feel like whenever you apply this, you just feel so good about yourself. You feel really pepped up, and that's one of the things that I love the most about this perfume. Then I have Nykaa's Moire range. This is the variant Joie de Vivre, but I love the pink one. It was so good. Someone actually broke my perfume, but I used to apply it every single day. These are really long lasting, guys. So if you're looking for affordable, like a budget product, this is 100ml, I guess. This is 100ml for 1800 rupees, which is a really good price point for a really long lasting perfume. I'm just trying to figure out. Yes, this is 100ml. So it's a really nice price point for 100ml, and it lasts so super long. So the broken bottle I've actually kept in my shoe cabinet. So all of my shoes now smell like that perfume, which is amazing. Then we have this perfume by Elie Saab. I can't really read the name anywhere, but again, I've not tried this one, so I can't tell you guys about the lasting power or anything. This is just something I sniffed and I picked up. This is Le Perfume. That's what it says, Le Perfume. So I'm gonna leave all of the notes right here so you can check it out. Next, we have Touch by Burberry. Again, this is something, it's a gift. I haven't really tried it on yet. but it's a cutely packaged product. Again, this is not something I picked up. I really like Burberry's body though. I don't have it with me right now because we've used it up, but Burberry body is so good. This is what it looks like. I like the packaging. It's really nice. It's cute. Next up, we have the Air and Mediterranean Honeysuckle. Now, this is a sister brand of Estee Lauder. It's actually headed by Estee Lauder's granddaughter, if I'm not mistaken. Now, this one is a very fresh perfume. It feels like you're on a vacation and you're just in between an ocean, surrounded with some flowers. It's a very beautiful perfume. This is what the packaging looks like. I love the blue stone touch on top of it. Again, if you are looking for something that's super fresh and just, you know, a pick-me-up, this is the one you should be trying out. Another one of my favorites has to be Oldie But a Goodie, a classic David of Cool Water. I really like the fragrance. I can't really describe it in my own words because I just feel it's such a beautiful, somber fragrance. It's just, it feels fresh, it feels calming, and I love it. I also love David of's Coffee, but David of overall is love. This is what the packaging looks like, and I can't help myself but sniff it. It's just so good. And yes, this is the regular one. It's not the one for women. I feel this one is a much better perfume. Then I have Girl of Now by Elisab. This is my one of the most recent purchases. I just bought it after coming back from Seychelles from the Delhi airport. First of all, the packaging looked gorgeous. Like gorgeous. This is so beautiful. But even the fragrance was so nice. I still have to check how long lasting it is. But as a first impression, I really like the mix of floral tones in there. So that's why I picked this one up. Another perfume that we picked up alongside the Elisab one was the Black Excess by Paco Rabanne. I have sniffed this. One of my cousin uses this and that's why we were like, let's just get this one. And the packaging also looks really cool. It looks like very gothic and just really nice. And I love how deep and dark this fragrance is. Again, I can't really tell you about the lasting part right now, but because I know that my cousin uses it and it lasts on her for all day long, I would say as a sort of thing that it is pretty long lasting. Now another one in my favorites from Avon has to be all of their dresses, their little red dress, white dress, black dress, all of them are beautiful. Now I have to say that if you're looking for budget, mid-budget sort of perfumes, Avon and Oriflame are the two best companies. Back in the day, because my mom's best friend was a rep for Avon and Oriflame, we used to buy so many perfumes from Avon and Oriflame, and we still have so many and they're so nice, especially little black dress. I have used so many bottles of this. I have so many miniatures of this as well. This is just one of it. I have the longer tubes and everything. I have all of the body lotions, like the full set and everything, for little black dress, little white dress, little red dress, for everything, and all of them are amazing. And then this perfume is literally 10 years old. I know this because we bought it from London Duty Free in 2009. This is Nina Ricci's. I don't know how to pronounce it. I'm not French and I don't judge how French people pronounce my name, so please don't judge me if I pronounce it incorrectly. This is L'Air du Temps. I hope that's correct. I don't know. But the packaging, oh my god, it's so beautiful. This is what the packaging looks like. It's like a bird on top and it's just so gorgeous. We've used up a lot of it because you don't really need a lot. It's a very strong fragrance and it stays on for a really long time as well. So again, thing with good long-lasting perfumes is because you don't end up using so much, it actually costs you cheaper. If you were to buy something that's super cheap but doesn't last for a really long time, you'll keep on reapplying it and in the longer run, you're ending up spending more money. It's a classical case of mehenga roye ek bar, sasta roye bar bar, and my grandfather taught that to me well, so I always look for quality over the pricing. Another Nina Ricci perfume that I have is Love in Paris. I don't even know, I think this is ancient. I don't know since when my mom has been holding on to this one, but it's such a beautiful evening perfume. I don't know how to say it, but it's an evening perfume. Sweet, sexy, feminine, just all of the things that you want to check on the list. It's such a good fragrance. Again, as always, Nina Ricci's perfume, this is super long lasting as well. Oh, then I have these two Oud perfumes from Dubai. These were very kindly sent to me by online makeup store India. Mariam, thank you so much. And these are the shades. I'm not even kidding you. I'm using Adhiram's Pocket spray perfume. So super long lasting. This one is next level. Ouds in general are very strong and I love it, but if you're someone who doesn't like it, stay away from it. But these will literally, again, they will stay on your clothes, stay with you for an eternity. These are so long lasting and so beautiful, so deep and dark, and just the perfect perfumes for me. Next, I have Victoria's Secret Crush. Now this is one of the perfumes that is not super like what I am. This is slightly on the different tone. I'll show you the packaging first because it's very pretty. It looks like the older perfumes. This is what it looks like, and you just pump out the perfume from here. Now this has light fruity, a very slight amount, and that's why I don't mind it. But this was sent to me by International Makeup India, so again thank you. This has slight fruitiness to it, but it's not overpowering to the extent that I get a headache from it. I think if you're someone who likes sweet fruity floral fragrances, you will love it. I find it okay, like I would wear it, but I wouldn't be like gaga over it. Similar to that packaging, we actually have Oriflame's Miss O. This came in a yellow variant, a pink variant, and this one's literally, oh my god, it's gone. The perfume's gone. I think I held on to it because of the packaging, which was just so cute. But I used the pink one, the yellow one. I don't know if they still make it. Oriflame, if you're still making it, love this stuff. All of the fragrances are so good. I'm just going to share more of my Oriflame and Avon perfumes now because I think we've had enough of Chanel's and Nina Ricci and YSL and Paco Rabanne. So I'm going to quickly move on to Avon and Oriflame because I have a shitload of perfumes from them. I have a Dancing Lady from Oriflame. I showed the full size of it in an empty video of mine because I love it. This is a smaller version because it's just pure love. This is such a nice perfume. It is slightly on the sweeter side, but it's super long lasting. Again, Avon and Oriflame does an amazing job with perfume. You can literally pick up whatever perfume that you like and suits your personality and liking, and it would be amazing. We have Paradise by Oriflame. I've never really tried it. I don't know when my mom bought it. I'm just gonna take it out. Ooh, that is some beautiful packaging. Like, look at that. They can easily compete with an high-end perfume. It looks so gorgeous. I don't know what it smells like. So it has a powdery smell. Like, it smells like a pond's powder. That's funny. I think my mom just bought it because of the packaging. She's the same as me when it comes to packaging. If we like the packaging, we're just like, add to cart. Then I have Precious Moments. Also, I think I have to say this. I don't even know if all of these perfumes are still being made by Avon and Oriflame because it's been a while since I've bought these. So if they're not, I'm really sorry. But if they still are, you might want to get your hands onto it. So this is what Precious Moments looks like. It has like a glitter shimmer particle inside it. Like, look at that, which settles down. So you have to shake it up every single time you use it. But look at that. Just look at that gorgeousness. So pretty. Smells divine. Stays on for a long time. That rhymes. Then we have Radiant Lights by Oriflame. Now this one is like, again, it has a slight fruitiness to it, but it's mixed with more muskier tones, which is why the fruitiness is bearable to me. Again, not one of my favorites out there, but if you're someone who loves fruity tones, then you're gonna love this one. That's it for Oriflame. Let's move on to Avon now. I have Outspoken by Fergie. I think I just bought it because it was a collab with Fergie. I'm pretty sure they're not making this one still because these are like limited edition things, but again, the packaging is just so gorgeous. It looks like a retro perfume, and this is a strong fragrance as well. It's not, you know, when you think of Fergie, you think of fruits and everything, but it's a very strong fragrance, very unlike her. So that's why I got this one, because again, it's a beautiful packaging and everything. I don't even remember what year this was, to be honest with you guys. It's been a while, a hot minute. Then we have Far Away Exotic. Now this one is more on muskier tone, if I remember correctly. And again, like, I mean, I just love how they package their products. This is more muskier, more deeper and more ambery when it comes to it. So if you're a person who loves musks and ambers, you're gonna love it. Personally, I like them to be mixed with something. I'm not a straight up musk or a straight up, you know, woody person at all. I love amber, but not straight up musk. Then we have Urban Flowers, the perfect example of what I was talking about. This one is a mix of woody and florals. So it's not supremely like woody, but it also has the hit of a floral in there and a very slight undertone of woodiness. So if you're someone who likes that woodiness but don't want it to be overpowering, Urban Flowers, sort of a perfume, if it's still available, that is for you. Then I have another one of a really good fragrance from Avon, which is Yasmin. And this is so good, you guys. It's just a really beautiful perfume. As you can see, we really love it. And it's, again, a very long-lasting one as well. It has a bit of leafiness in there and then a little bit of floral tones in there. It's a very different perfume and it's a beautiful one at it. Next up, I have Make Me Wonder. They had this whole series with Make Me Wonder, Make Me Dance, Make Me This, Make Me That. don't make me a mehenga lehenga. But yes, again, these are really nice perfumes if you just want to like try out something new and you're not really sure, because it just, they look, they were affordable if I am not mistaken. Now this particular one is a sweet one. I have one that I'm using daily, Make Me Dance, I guess, which is more feminine. This is sweet with a bit of fruitiness to it. I think we bought all of the perfumes and that's why we have this, and that's why it's never been used till now, because none of us are like a fruity fragrance person, neither my mom nor me. So maybe that's why this is still inside. Not my favorite, but cute. Then I have Saryul. We used, again, multiple bottles of this. This is such a beautiful fragrance. I hope Avon is still making this, because I really want some of you to get your hands on it. This is what it looks like. Oh my god, it's so beautiful. I have to sniff it. It's a dark feminine fragrance. I don't know how to describe fragrances, and I really wish you could sniff this, but again, I'm gonna write the undertones here so you can actually, you know, make out what it would sniff like. Also, I just want to give an honorable mention here to Passion Dance from Avon as well. I'm using that on a daily basis right now. So beautiful, so deep, so dark, so long lasting, beautiful. If it's still available, grab it before it goes away forever. Okay, also have Instinct. Don't remember this. Let me just take it out. My mom has been hoarding these. She doesn't even give them to me. So this is what the perfume looks like. This has a touch of camellia, a little bit of sandalwood, a little bit of everything just mixed in there. So it's woody and floral and just all things nice. I don't really remember the lasting part or anything of this one. I don't even remember the perfume in itself. I just like sniffed it and I could smell all of those coming through. But yes, I'm sure this would be nice because it has Avon over there, and Avon does really good fragrances. Then I have Truth by Calvin Klein. It's a very clean fragrance, a very fresh, clean fragrance is how I would describe this perfume as. This is what it looks like. Again, it's not sweet, it's not woody, musky, it's a clean fragrance. I don't know if that makes sense to any of you. Like, if you're a perfume junkie, you would totally understand what I'm saying. Then I have this random perfume from Stitch that I bought, I'm pretty sure, from UK back in 2009. We've never used this. I don't know why we picked it up. I think this was in like the pound store or something, and that's why we picked it up. And I am not sure what it smells like. We just random. Oh, that doesn't sound. Smells vinegary. I don't think we're gonna be using this. Next up, I have Femme Individual by Montblanc. Really love this perfume. Really beautiful perfume and long lasting, like long lasting. The bottle looks something like this, has the Montblanc thing on top. Now this one is a softer fragrance. It's not in your face. It's a very subtle, soft fragrance that stays throughout the day. Then we have the Bulgari Pour Homme. This is a unisex perfume. Like it says, it's unisex. All perfumes are unisex. If you want, you can wear an aftershave and call that a perfume, to be honest. But this is what it looks like. Now this one is a very gender neutral fragrance. You can't really say that it has a lot of musk in there or a lot of floral in there. It's a mix of everything so that anyone can wear it. Then I have Essenza Rebuild Ignite Floor. I've not tried this. I got this in the PR, so I don't know what it smells like. I haven't even seen it. Oh, cute packaging. I like the packaging. It smells on the fruity side. It already emits like a fruity fragrance in the air. I don't think I'm gonna like this that much. Then I have the Biotique fragrance. This is Blissful Lavender. I honestly can't smell that much lavender. Lavender is one of my favorite fragrances, if you don't know that about me. I honestly can't smell that much of lavender, but it's a very nice perfume, and Biotique as a perfume genre is doing really well. Like, the perfumes are actually very long lasting. So if you're looking for more affordable perfumes, try out Biotique. Then I have this Body Cupid Sweet Passion. Smell a lot of jasmine in there. I got this in the PR. I haven't really tried it out, so I can't talk about the longevity, but it smells very much like jasmine. So if you're a fan of that fragrance, then you might want to try this one out. Now this one, I'm not sure. I got it in some PR. It says my name. I just wish the J was capital as well. I don't really know who sent it, who didn't. It's a very sweet fragrance, a very, very sweet fragrance. I haven't tried it, but I sort of forgot where this one is from, so I'm really sorry. To quickly wrap things up, I want to talk about minis and how they're a great way to try out a perfume without just spending all of your money into it. I have the set by Bulgari, the Omnia set. It's affordable-ish for three perfumes. You might want to check this out. I haven't tried it. Then I have the Estee Lauder set. Now, funny story, my Nanaji had the original one that came out and he really wanted to try this out. So I ordered this one for him, and all of the fragrances in this one are beautiful and really long lasting. I think my favorite has to be Pure White Linen, beautiful fragrance. And then I have this one by Avon. This is Today, Tomorrow, Always. One of my favorite ranges that Avon did after the little dresses as well. These are a set of three perfumes. This is how it looked like. So cute, right? Then I have a lot of minis from Etude House, which are really long lasting. They're great to carry in your bag. And I also have one by Juicy Couture, which is very, very fruity. What did you expect? But yes, that was my perfume collection. I hope you guys enjoyed this. If you did, then don't forget to comment and subscribe. I'll see you guys next time. Till then, take care. Mwah.